a couple of issues come up of the importance of calling this pause, because people say, what does a pause mean? It really allows both the FDA and the CDC to further investigate these cases to try and understand some of the mechanisms of what it is, some more details about the history of the individuals who were involved that might shed some light on looking forward, what will happen and what we will do. That's the first thing. The other thing is to make physicians out there aware of this, and there are some clinical implications of that that I believe are important. For example, if someone comes in with this really rather rare syndrome of thrombotic thrombocytopenia, where you get thromboses, and when you have thromboses, the most common way to treat that is with heparin. That would be a mistake in this situation because it could be dangerous and make the situation much worse. So there's a clinically relevant reason why you want to make this known to people. Also, when individuals, particularly younger women, who might come into a physician with a particular thrombotic phenomenon, which is things that happen for other reasons all the time, that we want to alert physicians to take a history of a recent vaccination. That would be important. So the pause not only allows us to take a look at the cases and learn more, but it is also a signal out there to help the physicians. A common question, and I'm sure we'll have a number of questions which Jeff and I will be happy to answer to you, but one of the questions that comes up already rather frequently, does this have anything to do with the efficacy of the vaccine? So we know that there have been 6.85 million doses of J&J distributed in the United States thus far. So someone who maybe had it a month or two ago would say, what does this mean for me? It really doesn't mean anything. You're okay, because if you look at the frame, the time frame when this occurs, it's pretty tight from a few days, 6 to 13 days from the time of the vaccination. The next question is one that we're all obviously aware of. What impact is this going to have about people's attitudes about vaccines in general? So you might know that there have been now 120 million people that have received at least one dose of a vaccine. Most of that, subtract the 6.85 million, is in the messenger RNA from Pfizer and from Moderna. There have been no red flag signals from those. So you're talking about tens and tens and tens of millions of people who've received vaccine with no adverse effect. This is a really rare event. If you look at what we know so far, there have been 6 out of the 6.85 million doses, which is less than 1 in a million. So remember, this is something that we always, out of an abundance of caution, as Jeff said, to give us a time to take a good look at it and see if we can get further information.